Sandra over at SewSpire.com, and today I am here to show you how to sew this fabulous market tote bag. This is a great size bag for travel. It is completely machine washable and crafted from quilt weight cotton fabric. For this project, you're going to want about 3 yards of material and approximately 3/4 yards of batting, in addition to a swivel key fob and a oversized button cover set, because we make a custom button for this. So shall we get started? Okay, so for this project, we're going to begin with the exterior pockets, and all of the pattern pieces and measurements will be down in the notes field, so you do not have to try and write that all down. You can just reference that in one place. You're also welcome to head on over to SewSpire.com, and you'll find a post with a project roundup there. That's probably your best bet. So to begin, you're going to need 2 pieces of cotton fabric that measure 18 inches wide by 15 inches tall, and both of those will be lined with quilt batting, and they will become the exterior body panels. So we'll set those up there so we can craft the exterior pocket, which is also made from 2 pieces of quilt weight cotton fabric that measure 12 inches by 18 inches, and take the tops of those pieces and fold them over and press a nice edge there. And that was about 3/4 inch. And then you're going to take the pocket and layer that on top of that folded edge, so you create like a little piped look there. And that gives the pocket some added interest as well as some rigidity across the top. So we're just gonna line that up so it peeps over approximately 1/4 inch, and then stitch all the way down that top edge. Okay, so you can see I stitched across there, and you can see that little piped edge sticking up. Now I like to go back and add one more accent row of stitching, so you have essentially a double stitch line. And then that adds a finished look to that pocket, like you might have with your jeans or such. Okay, so take one of your exterior body panels with the batting, and you're going to position the pocket with the raw edges aligned at the bottom and the sides aligned. And with the way that the exterior is constructed, we want to ensure this pocket is going to fold under the base of the bag. And what we want to do is secure that pocket with a seam or a stitch, so that the contents of the pocket do not float underneath the bag. So after you have your pocket aligned on here, fold up that exterior layer, and then approximately 3 inches from the bottom, fold up that liner of the pocket and just crease that so you have a stitch line. And what you're going to do is just stitch along that interior to seal up that pocket, so that when you put contents in it, it won't float all the way under. Okay, now once you have that line there, you can fold back down that exterior, and now you don't even see that hidden seam there. And you're going to want to divide your pocket in half. I happen to piece 2 pieces of material together, and you can see that seam in the middle. So I have a nice straight line to stitch down to divide that exterior pocket. If you don't, just fold that fabric or mark center, and you're going to stitch straight down the center of that pocket to divide it in half. With the market totes, I come on either side of that stitch and create 3 rows of stitching on that front pocket. So the front panel is complete, and I have 2 wide, deep pockets there. I'm going to take the back exterior body panel, which is lined with the quilt batting, and position that on top. I'm just going to turn this around so the pockets are facing up, and then paying attention to the direction of these awesome skulls, I'm going to position the fabric and batting panels right sides facing, and then using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, I'm going to stitch all the way down the sides and across the base, leaving that top open. Okay, I've made it all the way around. You just want to check and make sure that you've captured all the layers. And then just at this top edge here, approximately 3 inches in, trim off all that excess so we don't have a lot of bulk when we're trying to stitch the top on. Then we're going to use a fat corner to create the depth of this bag. And the way you do that is you open it up and then align the side seam with the base. And I want this bag to be approximately 4 inches deep. So using my mat here, I'm gonna measure across 4 inches on that triangle. You can mark it if you like, but a nice little tip, that pocket stitch that we put in there is hitting right at that 4-inch width, even though that was stitched 3 inches up. So that's perfect. So I can just use that stitch line and continue across there to create the depth of the bag. And I'm going to repeat that on the other side so that we can fashion the base of this bag. And then you can go ahead and trim off those corners to the right of the stitch line. And you can see now that the bag has its depth. So you can turn this right side out. And that's what those corners look like. And then this bag does not have a lot of rigidity with the quilt batting, but it will stand on its own, and with the contents inside, it will also stand on its own. But the reason that I use quilt batting for this is I like to wash my bags, and they will wash up beautifully with the quilt batting. So for the exterior, go ahead and fold that top edge inward approximately 1 inch. And if you want, you can press that. I think that this is going to stay nice for me. So I'm going to fold that in and then set the exterior aside while we craft the interior. Now the interior is basically crafted in the same way, except we're going to use a slightly different technique for the pockets, which are going to be divided in thirds. So the interior panels are also 15 inches tall by 18 inches wide. And it has 3 pockets, which you're going to use 2 pieces of cotton fabric that are 9 by 18, and fold both the top and the bottom edges over and press. Then go ahead and stagger that fabric to create that lip again. And you'll want to stitch that across the top of that pocket. I do not put the second row of stitching on the inside because nobody's going to see it, but you can if you like. Okay, so the top edge of the pocket is finished, and then I take that and fold it in thirds and just crease that stitch line with my nail so I can keep that nice and straight. Then I'm going to open this up and position that pocket 4 inches from the base. So the finished edge is along the top, and then I have 4 inches from the base. And I have my press lines in there. I may use 2 pins to hold that. And I'm going to begin by stitching across the base of the pocket to secure it to the panel and then dividing that into thirds. Okay, so the interior pocket panel is complete and it's been divided in thirds. I want to take the remaining interior panel and position that right sides facing. Then we're going to craft this interior exactly like we did the exterior by stitching down the sides across the base and then giving it that 4-inch fat corner. Okay, the interior is complete. That's easy. Now we take that top edge and fold that over approximately 1 inch. And you can press it at the iron, or if your fabric is already crisp, your hand should work just fine. And you can see we have the three-way divided slip pocket in there. You want to bring back the exterior and fit that interior lining in there. I put the pockets facing the exterior rear of the bag so that you have the front pockets and then the interior pockets are on the back, and this just helps distribute the weight of the bag. But you want to begin pinning your lining at the seam, so you're going to align both seams, and then once you have those side seams aligned, go ahead and fashion and align the rest of the bag and secure that with pins. Okay, and I have that lining in there, and now it is time to craft the handles. So I'll set that aside for a few minutes. The handles are made from two pieces of fabric, which measure 6 inches wide by 24 inches long. And this is my standard handle, which you are probably very familiar with. You're going to fold that fabric in half, press it, open that up, and then bring those folded edges inward to meet on that center press line. And I have inserted a piece of quilt weight batting there that is slightly shorter than the handle and 3 inches wide. So it just fits right inside of that channel. And then fold the handle over one more time. And you're going to begin by stitching down that folded edge and then the opposite edge to finish. And you'll repeat that twice so you have two handles for this bag. Okay, both handles are done. We're going to bring back over the bag here. And I want to position those handles in between the interior and the exterior layers, approximately 4 inches from those outer seams. And you just tuck that handle inside of there about 1.5 inches. You want to check and make sure both of your handles are the same distance, and that looks good. This is an average handle drop there. You can see it fits nice on the shoulder. If you need it longer, just simply increase the length of your straps, and I'll tell you exactly what the drop on this one is. That's 10 inches, so that's an average. If you are going to be using this in the winter, or you like a lot of room over the shoulder, you might want to increase that strap length 2 to 4 inches, okay? So now we want to craft the key fob, which is made in the same way as the handles without batting, and that's 6 inches by 9 inches, and you just fold that and press in the same way. to create a strap and then stitch down the open edge and the opposite side to finish. Then I got these fobs at Hobby Lobby and they're just 1.5 inch wide swivel fobs and they come 2 to a package and I feel like they're less than $4, which is a nice price. And you just take that top edge and thread that on top to create the key fob loop. And then you can position that in between the interior and the exterior layers on either side. I usually have it towards the front of the bag off to the left if you're facing the bag. So it looks like that. And then this will allow you to put the keys on and tuck it inside, or if you need to find them, you can have them on the outside tucked into that exterior pocket. And the next step, we want to create the little tab closure. And so this is 3 inches wide by 12 inches long, and you create that in the same way, same folding technique, and stitch down both sides. Then you have a nice strap there, which you're going to take and find center and then fold that up. Keep holding that and then fold it up one more time. And this is going to create, I don't even know what shape to call that, but it's like a folded tabby. And you're going to stitch across that so it remains in place. And then I'll show you a close up of that. So this will catch your button tab. It'll create the button tab and then your button will sit right there on that little fold that you created. So this also gets tucked in between the handles and the interior and exterior layers. That's what it looks like on the back side, and then you'll pull that tab over and loop it around the button to close the bag. So we have to create our fabric cover button. For this, you're going to need a 3 by 3 inch piece of material and then a oversized button kit, which comes with the back, the front, and then the little tool that helps you create the covered button. There's usually 2 buttons per package. So take the fabric, find the piece that you would like to show on the button and center that, and then press with that top rounded dome, press that into the clear tool that came with that. And you'll tuck all that fabric inside of that button dome. And then you take your cap with the back on it that you'll use to attach it to the bag and position that on top of that. And then the solid smaller piece that came with the button kit goes like that. And you just press that in place. And they're very, very easy to create. And you just push that around like that so it's secure. And then you can, pop out your button and you have a super adorable custom button, which you will then attach. For when I'm attaching buttons, I like to use the button craft thread. It's very strong and it's meant to be used exactly for this purpose. So I get a generous cut of thread and I use a bigger needle for this as well. And I double thread that and I come in between the interior and the exterior layers right at the center point there, approximately 3/4 of the way down from the top edge of the pocket and the top edge of the bag. So I'll bring that through from the underside of the exterior layer through that button shank and then back around. And again, this thread is really strong, so I don't find that I need to double this, but if it makes you feel better, certainly loop around a couple times. What I think really is important is that knot, and I will tie several knots in this. And then I will also leave that string nice and long and just tuck that down in there. Okay, so the button has been attached. You can do a little test fit and make sure you're happy with that. You might need to extend the distance that you have the flap tucked in there, but if everything fits nice, which this does, then you are all set to stitch the, what I call the top on this bag. So you're going to remove the deck of your machine and then go ahead and slide the bag on that machine deck. I start at the side seam and I just move all the way around that top edge. I do reinforce the handles with the back stitch, and if you like, if you're going to have very heavy loads, come back in and put a second row of stitching. Okay, I made it all the way around. This thing is super cute. That was a quick and easy sew. You can see it sits right on the shoulder nice. And you've got 5 pockets to keep everything organized. This is a perfect bag for travel as well, because you could just fold that up and tuck it inside of your suitcase. And then when you get to your destination, you have a really stylish bag, which is why I named it the Market Tote. So you can head off to those markets and fill it up with treasures. So I will be back soon with another inspired project. I want to invite you to tune into this week's studio update, because we are going to be giving away this beautiful bag to a lucky Happy Mail winner. So we'll announce that in the studio update. And if you haven't had a chance, please join my newsletter mailing list over at sewspire.com, and you will receive our weekly email update as well. So thank you again for sewing with me. It was an absolute pleasure. I will be back next week with another inspired project, and until then, please know the creative genius in me celebrates the creative genius in you. Have a beautiful week, everyone.